I'm Dr. Snyder, and I'm the lead physician at the Armstrong Mental Institution. At this domicile, we access and correct. I've been working here for about 10 years, and I've seen a lot of patients come and go over the years. Patients have been documented, video documented, for research and awareness. Here are some clips of previous patients at our mental facility suffering from depression, post-traumatic stress disorder, dissociative identity disorder, and these disorders were varying in severity. Viewer discretion is advised.
Why don't you introduce yourself?
Hello, my name is Sandra and I'm a patient here.
Now Sandra, how long have you been here?
I have been here for about 3 years now.
And why is that?
Well, I have bipolar depression and I found that I can no longer care for my well-being.
So what's it like having bipolar depression?
On my bad days, I can hardly do anything by myself. Every day's a struggle. But on my good days, I feel like I can do anything I put my mind to. I become very active, productivity-wise, of course.
What's your name?
Willow.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how bad is your depression?
9.5.
Why is your depression so severe?
From the ages 6 to 12, my parents abused me, then left me, and I was forced to live with my aunt and my uncle. They also abused me, they forced me to live in the basement, then they left me in town, they never came back. 1 year later, I found myself in Armstrong Mental Institution.
I used to fight fires, and I was darn good at it. But tragedy strikes even the most careful people. It was a normal day. Then a 72-8 call came in, and I donned my gear. Engine 72 and I raced to the scene. 3 men and I entered the building. We got 10 feet in the building when a beam fell onto me and burned my face. But I wasn't the only person to lose something that day. While I was waiting for help, I watched as a sergeant, a corporal, and Engine 72's beloved captain were crushed by the second floor as it collapsed on top of them.
Six years. I still can't believe it. I still can't believe how that day went. How did I make it? How was I the one to survive when we lost so many people that day? I can't believe that of all the people that we lost, that you, one of my best friends, is gone, and it's been 6 whole years. How did I make it? How am I still here? Why am I still here? I don't even know where the time has gone and how I'm supposed to live my life here. It's hard to believe it's been 6 long years. 6 years! I can't do this anymore. Get out! Go! Get out! I can't do this! I can't take it anymore!
The eldest of the corners, a girl who wore a triangle shawl, its corners draggling on the stubble, carried her arms at what first sight seemed to be a doll.
You know you forgot your homework.
What are you talking about? I did it already. I turned it. Miss Ramey hates you. No, she doesn't. You know you do. You're stupid. You're failing that class. No, I didn't. No, it's fine. Tess Duberville had one. You can't even say her name right. Stop it. She sat down at the end of the corner, face turned, stumbled away. Companions, you don't even have any companions. Stop it. Men who sat near us sternly turned, faced toward. Stop reading, you. You're not smart enough to be in that class. Stop it. I'm fine. All the women spoke to me, talked, and adjusted the strange knots. You're not gonna pass. I'm gonna pass. Wow, you can't even read? And you call yourself smart. I don't call myself smart. I don't. I just think you're not good enough for this. I'm fine. Oh, yeah, you're real good. You're real fine, aren't you? No! Shut up.
Did Allie come visit you today?
No.